Season 5, Episode 6, A Bat Over a Barrel.
All right, Buddy and Susan, while we finish putting on our Halloween costumes, I want you to tell me how many straw men you see guarding the trick-or-treat portal.
Seven!
Very good! Now here's the cute little pouches I made for you to hold the webbing. Oh, they're so cute and you look so darling! Sorry, get a hold of yourself, Weaver. Now do you remember what to do, Buddy and Susan?
Yes!
Now remember to act like your Halloween costume.
We're ninjas!
I'm a beautiful ninja!
Mr. Rochester, is our friend Rocky the Stone Golem ready?
Most assuredly, Mrs. Weaver. The citizens and I are standing by at the trick-or-treat portal.
Now we send in Mr. Goliath with the distraction. And go!
Do-do-do-do, walking my dog near the barricaded trick-or-treat portal. Do-do-do-do-do-do.
Hey, quit licking.
Oh, Dret, I apologize for my spirited hellhound. He must like you.
Now, Buddy and Susan!
Ninja, 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 ninja.
Hey, we can't move.
They taught us to get real strong.
Now say hello to this elegant spiderweb tablecloth. Now, Rocky, tear down the barricades! The portal is open, everyone! Now let's get over to Earth and get this town some fright power!
Let's go, Goliath.
Let's go!
Here you go, citizens. As a deputized trick-or-treat monitor, I encourage you to go one at a time for your safety. Enjoy your Halloween!
Weaver the Team Batstopper, we're sending Rocky your way!
10-4.
All right, Buddy and Susan, let's go trick-or-treating!
Caywomas!
Y'all in Curdle Holler.
Curdle Holler, 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 Curdle Holler.
Welcome to your afterlife.
So it looks like the red carnation pin communicators are working perfectly. You're so amazing, Minerva.
Stop. But look. I can also open any channel to talk to one team at a time. This is the street team at the town square, led by the handsomest zombie butler in town. Hey, Roddy.
Minerva, I am undeserving of your accolades. You brilliant she-beast.
Well, we know the street team is crushing it. Minerva, do you have everything that you need here for Team Cone?
Yeah. I've got a monitor hooked up to the fright crystal that displays our fright power level. I've got Bloopy defragmenting.
Hello!
I've got Fibula online.
Baby!
And I'm hacked into Albert's mind palace for good measure.
Hello, Bonita.
Hi, guys! Bloopy, I'll see you later.
Hello!
Okay, overloading Bloopy with fright power is part one of the plan. Part two is the storming of the Company Holler compound. That's gonna be Belfry's team. They're en route. I don't know if they have a cute name or not.
Ooh, Nita, how about Team Whistle?
Foreman has the whistle, remember? The whistle that summons the straw men?
Yes, Team Whistle. And part three of the plan is me, Chip, and the Sheriff confronting Roostifer face to face.
Team Batstopper.
All right, y'all, Roostifer is turning townspeople into straw men as we speak and zooping our town over to Earth. This ends today.
On Halloween, today we ride for Curdle Holler.
Woohoo! Team Batstopper.
Yeah, let's roll.
Nita, keep your volume down on that communicator. I don't want it getting fried.
All right.
And Chip, no root beer in the communicator, all right?
I'll try my best.
All right now, somebody is stepping on my foot.
Could be me, as I feel a much larger foot below my foot. Ow!
Sheriff, how much longer you reckon we'll be hiding from searchlights in a company holler porta-potty?
Any minute now, Ms. Von Wangencamp. I almost learned the exact pattern of the watchtowers. Them straw men's got pretty riled about how we come busting through them gates just now.
It's like they didn't know we had a 10-foot golem on our texting thread.
Okay, so we're heading straight across the works and into Roostifer's office, right?
Yes, ma'am, and the coast is clear. Run!
Well, fellas, Roostifer's clearly not in his weird office / leather cigar president lounge.
I smell cigar smoke, which means he was here, and smokers are jokers.
Don't make no sudden moves, y'all. He could be hiding in this very office. He could be in this here drawer! Just kidding, Miss Von Wangencamp. That's a joke to lighten the mood.
Okay.
Hey, Sheriff, you see the old-timey globe?
Yeah, boy, what's where a point? That's where you gonna live.
That's fair.
All right, Chip, you gonna live in Grand Duke, Luxembourg.
Whoa, okay. Hey, what's happening?
Well, it looks like the floor is opening into a giant pit from the middle of the room, and the only door is on the other side.
Oh, hey, it's a trap.
From the Grand Duke of Luxembourg, or Roostifer Badsinger.
Okay, and the pit just became officially too big to jump over. That's good.
We need a real good plan right now, and go!
Live in the pit. Okay, sorry, I panic. I mean, give up!
Chip! Use your adventure whip from geology.
Yes, hold on, everybody.
Fair warning, I pass a little wind when I get nervous and
Hurry, Chip.
One, two, geology.
Nice work, Transylvania Jones.
Don't thank me, thank Tentacle Whip. And then thank me, and then tell everyone what I did.
Hey, y'all think I should get me a lasso just in case it's like two traps at one time?
Good point, Sheriff. Roostifer knows we're on his trail, so we have to be on guard for more surprises, which is very rude and terrifying.
Whoop, look here what I just found in the garbage.
Packaging for fake mustaches.
The perfect disguise for planet Earth.
To the loophole!
Wampus to Team Cone. Come in, Team Cone.
You got Team Cone.
We are victorious in the liberation of the trick-or-treat portal. Indeed, some citizens are cannonballing their way through the portal, such as their feral Halloween enthusiasm. I even convinced the straw men to go through, after extricating them from Mrs. Weaver's spider-web bonds, of course.
Great job, babe. I can already see some new hash marks on the fright power meter. Everything's looking good so far.
Minerva, darling. From my vantage point, I can see a faint glimmer in the giant ice cream cone. It has begun to coruscate like the beautiful gray matter protruding from your skull.
Yeah, it's nice to see the old girl starting to get back to normal.
I regret to inform you, however, that a few buildings have disappeared to Earth. Armando's Talon Grill has grilled its last frog leg.
All the more reason to stay the course, you dapper cadaver. Team Cone out. Fibula, are you ready to do your part?
Yes, baby. Don, you gonna do it too?
Rawr.
Yeah,
Fright, stand by. I'm sending you through to every node of the public address system in Company Holler. Have you recorded your emergency message?
I recorded it, baby. It's going straight to the top of the charts already.
Well, let's hear it. Hey, Nita, do you want to hear Fibula's message for Company Holler?
Well, we're chasing Roostifer to Earth right now, and there's a lot of passageways, so sure.
We should have worn more sensible shoes.
Yeah, story of our lives.
Hey, listen up, babies of the mines. This is an emergency, and you need to get out, babies. Roostifer Bussinger be turning you into straw men, so you've got to go to the exit, baby. Remember, be a ghoul boss, baby. Don't work in the mines. Be a ghoul boss, baby. It's your time to be a ghoul boss, baby. Now here's your plan. Put on your high-heeled shoes and stand up to the band. Sing it, dog.
And that message is now being broadcast on repeat throughout Company Holler.
Fibula, it's great. I love it. No notes.
Yeah, same. Love it. Not sure the song was necessary.
Baby, don't talk crazy. This song is very necessary. Nelly Nebula be in here going, oh, and I got to cover that up somehow. Shh, I know, baby. Now everybody dance. You too, Nelly. There you go. That's good. Get out.
You can't live in a cave, Terry. That's weird.
Then how come I've been living in a cave being awesome since I've been here, which you would know, except you ain't never been to my house, Casey?
Whatever.
A cave is like a dirt garage.
What you think, Straw Man?
Y'all leave Straw Man alone now. He's skittish around strange teenage zombies and deputy trolls.
What's his name, anyway?
Yeah, what's his name, Bubble Butt?
You may call me Mr. Belfry, or Bat Singer, and the Straw Man has forgotten his name, but he is the Foreman. That means the boss, ain't that right, Mr. Foreman?
I'm the boss.
What's his deal again?
Well, young Terry, when we locate our friends and their captors, the Foreman will blow his magic whistle, and them other Straw Men gon' snap to and obey his every command.
That's cool. He sets the tone.
He can sit with us at the cool table.
Now, children, up here y'all need to be quiet as a coffin, because the Foreman, he ain't gonna help us none if them guards find us and get hold of that magic whistle. Or they run away, or raise the portcullis, or, you know...
Hey, who puts you in charge anyway?
Yeah, we don't respect substitutes.
Plus, you still on my watch list for double attempt apocalypse!
Apocalypse?
Long time ago.
Like a year ago.
You might turn on us, man, and join up with the Scarecrow Gang.
Well, y'all just have to trust me like the Foreman here. If I get out of line, y'all can just whop me upside the head and cart me off to jail. Fair?
You got it. That's fair, sir.
That's fine.
All right, then. All right, y'all. Let's hold up here. That's some of our friends and neighbors up yonder need rescuing.
Hey, y'all work harder.
We can't.
Marco, it's your stepdad.
Hi, do we have a union?
Nobody stresses out stepdad but me.
All right now, we're going to sit here real quiet and wait for that straw man guard to get close so he can hear the foreman's whistle real good. All right, foreman, got your whistle?
I got it. All
right, y'all, not much longer. Y'all just wait now.
Hey, Casey, look. A crawdad.
Cool!
Uh-oh, y'all, what's this?
Any time now, Mr. Foreman. Blow that whistle.
Okay, I blow it. I do it.
You're gonna have to be louder, man! Or we gonna have to fight these old haystacks!
You. Sit crisscross applesauce.
Ain't doing it!
Just like in school.
Yeah, there he is. Good job.
Obey the tooth, y'all. Mandrakes, y'all gonna be all right?
At last, we're free!
Free, 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 free!
Marco, I'm so happy to see you!
Cool it, Dad. You're embarrassing me.
You call me Daddy.
Yeah, but like, be cool about it.
Okay, I love you.
Okay, Dad.
Belfry, can you hear me?
Go ahead, Miss Minerva.
We got a fright power spike coming from your location.
That's cause me and the teen team here just freed us some Halloween spirits.
Good. Tell them to head for the Halloween portal and drum up some more scares on Earth.
Affirmative. We'll see who else we can rescue.
I do it.
Y'all go on in. I'll guard the loophole in case old Roosterfer tries to sneak back through this here cranny.
Thanks, Sheriff.
We'll bring you back a present.
It feels so wrong still seeing the boutique on Earth. Like it's just some regular gift shop that sells t-shirts and keychains. I mean, we sell that too, but it's Halloween keychains and the t-shirts don't even make sense if you're not dead.
Can you imagine Earthlings wearing Y2 decay shirts?
Speaking of madness, am I hallucinating or do I see Pumpkin outside the boutique? Pumpkin? You want some candy?
I'll take a Gutterfinger. What are you doing out here?
Talking to some lady.
Me?
Nope.
We're trying to find Roosterfer Batsinger, Pumpkin. Have you seen him?
I seen that Batman draw them zoops on the floor, and I say, stay out of the candy business, but he won't do a pumpkin promise. So now I have to make a revenge.
Which way did he go?
Yonder.
Curses don't draw no ugly words in my summon symbols. We must waste no time on our creepy corner preparations.
Bonita, don't hold me to it, but I'm pretty sure that mustachioed child is Percy Batsinger.
Well, I wasn't sure, but then he started flying and eating mosquitoes.
Oh no! Here comes another building! It's the salon! Sally's Talon and Claws!
Yeah, this is just between us, but at least so far they're not good buildings.
Percy, come on! We've been made!
Crap, he saw us. And he's running for the loophole!
Stop right there, Batsingers!
Later, Biscuit Heads!
Biscuit Head?
Straw men, make safe our passage. Detain these rebel revenants. Chip Clearly, you and that woman are committed to a futile endeavor. It is fate that I will have your Halloween tail, and you shall have not.
That's right, Tater Tots. Us Batsingers get whatever we want.
They went through, which means Roosterfer is back in Company Holler.
Yep, let's hope the sheriff has better luck.
Here we are, team. Second level of the mine.
This elevator is getting crowded.
Yeah, man, it's like a clown car in here, which is not a very cool kind of car, you dig?
It's not cool, Marco. You're right.
Hush up, we out for now. Watch your step. Let us wait for the rest of our group to catch up. Foreman and the other straw men are on their way down.
You want me to hurry them up? Watch this, old Batsinger!
Now, Miss Tarrant, there's no need to jostle the skip horse like that. What if you tear it down with your prodigious strength?
Hey! You want to spend a million years waiting on some old up and down bucket, or do you want results?
Touché. Let's reform our ranks, soldiers. Miss Terry and I up front, Foreman and the straw men in the middle.
I do it.
Miss Casey and young Marco, are y'all good back there bringing up the rear?
Cool kids at the back of the line.
Right on.
Let's proceed.
Hey, y'all, look. I see some of them other old hay bales down this way.
You're not supposed to be here.
Why do I feel like I, like, know this guy?
What you talking about? All these old brooms look the same to me.
Terry, don't you know who this is? It's Mr. Fly. He got turned into a straw man.
It's true.
Dang, Mr. Fly. What happened to you, old buzzhead?
Why, he looks meek as a kitten. Mr. Fly, you coming with us now? We gonna get you above ground and zooping around some delectable garbage in no time.
He's like making me sad.
It's a real bummer, man.
Just now, young people. Look up here, these two still working. Sam, Chuck, come on now, y'all.
Quitting time. Now come with us.
Well, well, well. If it isn't... Wait a minute. I forgot what I'm supposed to do here. Better keep shoveling.
Didn't y'all hear the foreman? Toot toot now. We here to rescue y'all from your toil in the mines.
Oh! Ooh, la-dee-da. They're gonna rescue us from the mines.
Oh, they're so heroic.
Just like in the movies.
Now, if you'll excuse us, we got a mine.
No mine. Quitting time.
So let me get this straight. A big gaggle of straw mans and Belfry Batsinger and some utes are telling us we can leave the mines because they're so commanding and we're so downtrodden? You hear that, Chuck?
Ooh, la-dee-da. Wait a minute. I think that's a good thing.
Yeah! Y'all can go on home to the ice cream store, you old roof-sitting rockheads!
Oh, and we have the store and the ice cream and the, your mother-in-law. Yeah.
Dear me. I wonder how many more of our once fearsome town's monsters have succumbed to the disorienting loss of fright power that is clearly plaguing these gargoyle boys.
Well, there's only one way to find out, Bazinga. We marching on. Y'all hear me?
Yeah, Terry's right.
Knock, knock, darling.
Wow. Hey, Roddy. I'm surprised to see you here. I was expecting to hear from you on the console.
Yes, the knocks are coming from inside the coffin, my terrifying tater tot. And speaking of...
You brought me lunch, my ghoulish galahad.
Yes, the streets are deathly quiet, so it seemed not unreasonable to leave my post at the trick-or-treat portal. How goes it up here?
Minerva, baby. I have a report.
Go ahead, Fibula.
There is no more little miners left in Company Holler. They all followed the beat of a new drummer.
Nice work.
I was gonna stop playing my emergency message, but the song's so cool, baby.
Team Batstopper to Team Cone.
You've got Team Cone.
Hey, just curious as to how close we are to overloading the fright power grid, because we need that surge to happen pretty soon.
Levels are near capacity and still going up. It's looking good, but I'm worried that these are asymptotic increases.
Meaning?
Meaning they'll get close to overloading the fright crystal, but won't touch the trigger point.
Okay, so what can we do to help it along? And keep in mind, we're all really mad and scary right now.
Bonita's got a new vein that's popping out of the other side of her forehead.
Priority one is stopping Roosterfer's waste of fright power. He's still powering his building Zoopover somehow. I've seen some fluctuations in the grid taking place in the refinery area.
Well, that's where we're headed right now, so it sounds like we're on the right track. Bonita out.
The eye of the were-tiger, that one. Minerva, aren't you proud of our surrogate daughter and the rest of the Halloween gang?
I'll be even prouder when they take down that clown.
Hello, I'm Bloopy. Please say a command.
Patience, Bloopy. Your moment will come soon.
Belfry to Miss Terry, do you read?
Go for Terry!
I'm coming up the mine shaft elevator with Miss Casey and Marco. May I kindly inquire as to the status of our straw man army and rescued citizens?
shoved all them citizens through that loophole in your daddy's old crud shack. They whooping it up trick-or-treating on Earth now, hoss.
My. And the straw men and foremen?
Some of them went trick-or-treat, but we got a whole bunch waiting up here for you, bazooka.
10-4.
Are we almost done going up and down this old elevator? It's taking forever. So embarrassing.
For real. I'm ready for a smoke break, daddy-o. But I can't light up down here. We might go gooly kablooey.
Smoking's a nasty habit, son, but we're about to the top of the mine. See? We seem to have come to a stop.
We're still kind of swinging. I don't think we're at the top.
Yeah, Bat-Pappy. Do you hear that unrighteous metal grinding? Something must be blocking our way.
My word, this cart is groaning like a ghost with arthritis. Whatever could be blocking us.
Whatever it is has a big round butt. Look.
It's like a solar eclipse in here. What with that big behind blocking all the light? Hello? Excuse me?
Hello?
Pumpkin, are you sitting in the skip horse bucket? You're blocking our way, son.
Hold on. I'm getting supplies.
I will never understand that fella.
Team Batstopper to Team Whistle. Come in, Team Whistle.
Foreman, I believe that's us. You've got Team Whistle.
So, not to stress anyone out, but we are rapidly on a course to cornering Roosterfur, and we really could use some backup.
Not to worry, my dear. I'm standing by with the youths, the foreman, and a whole gaggle of straw men. We up right outside the mines.
Hey, y'all.
And it looks like we've got Pumpkin, too.
Great, we're headed to the refinery.
Yeah, I lugged him with the big old dollop of slime, and we following his trail.
Meet us there as fast as you can. Bonita out.
Seems like we've got our marching orders, team. Let's reform our orderly ranks.
Let's do it, y'all! We thinking of fight our old man! Okay, I'll go with you.
That would do just fine, Pumpkin. But I thought you said you were getting some supplies.
I got them. They're in the pocket of my overalls. Well then, come on, Orange Hand! It's go time!
That. They do exactly what the big one tells them to do.
Boss.
Yeah, you the boss. Now come on, fellas. Huddle up. We about to do some real work now. Come on. There you go.
Mr. Straw Daddy, can you make the straw babies hold hands?
Hold hands.
That's reconnaissance complete, folks. It's the last of them guards in the whole refinery. Plus, I got Deputy Terry and her deputines watching all the exits for any ill-advised sneak attack.
Then all we need to do is follow our slime trail right through that door into the furnace room. That's where we'll find Rooster for Batsinger and take back Curdle Holler.
Nita, what's the word?
Hey, Minerva, objective complete. We have Rooster for cornered in the furnace room, and all the straw men are holding hands. We're about to head in.
Cool. Heads up. A lot of fright power activity in the room next door.
That's old Roosterfur up to something.
Perhaps a jumbo-sized zoop to grab the rest of our Halloween establishments.
That'd be my guess. Talk on the other side.
Belfry, I just want to say you done real good here lately. Taking them town notes and, building an army of strongmans to fight your daddy and that little boy. But, you gonna be okay in there? I hope we ain't got nothing to worry about.
I'm good, Sheriff, and I appreciate the comments. Chip, same question. You now know the power of my daddy's influence. Gonna be all right if he starts wagging his old tongue about this, that, as well as the other?
Absolutely. I give you the Chip clearly promise there will never be an I in mining.
That's a weird answer, Chip, but thanks. We see you, and I'm glad you're here.
Everybody hold hands.
Okay, I was going to do battle plans, but since we are, in fact, holding hands now, I will just say that I'm proud of you guys.
Oh, we rock stars.
Yes, you're rock stars. And no matter what happens in there, we will always be the real citizens of Curdle Holler.
Yeah, oh, really? All right, now. You ready?
Boutique Plus.
Mm-hmm. Go on three.
One, two.
Y'all, this place is huge.
Yep, I reckon it's about perfect for some evil machines and you hire goons playing cards and plenty of room for a nighttime rumble.
It's exactly where you'd fight the boss in a video game.
If he changed colors, he gonna do a super move.
That's true.
But look at here. The slime trail gone cold.
They must have used the eyewash station.
Whew, I could use a spritz myself. It's hot as seven hells in here.
Might be the molten furnace up ahead.
Y'all look up yonder at the top of them stairs.
Barrels? There must be thousands. And they are glowing with fright power. That must have been what Minerva was warning us about.
Okay, I remember from the factory tour that the fright power goes from those barrels into the company holler silo. That's the power source he uses to zoop our buildings over to Earth.
A wonderful tour, is it not?
Roosterfer!
You all cannot stop me, for I'm surrounded by the mightiest of strawman security. Note the extra stuffing for muscle shapes. Indeed, the only strawman tougher than these lot here, the only voice they will obey beside yours truly.
Boss.
The foreman.
He got that whistle, Daddy. He's stealing our straw beds.
Yes, he is. Now, hold on. Just a moment.
Don't you try nothing foolish, Daddy.
That sound you hear means my fright power is ready for activation. The buildings you saw on Earth were only practice for the main event. If you take but one more step, I will pull this here lever, and all the remaining buildings in Curdle Holler will move to creepy corners.
But you ain't talking about the library now. That ain't going nowhere.
Yes, even the library.
And Colonel Cadavers?
Oh, yes.
And the dojo?
Yes, all of them.
But what about the...
I said all the buildings. Don't take another step.
Give it up, Roosterfur. We have you cornered. Whatever you do now ends with you in a place called Hat City.
Ooh, that's good. But he don't know that means jail.
You all try to arrest me, and I will pull this lever.
Pull that lever, and we arrest you.
Then I suppose we are at an impasse. It is a disappointing development, to be certain. But any good businessman knows that fate turns on a dime.
Is this going somewhere?
I propose, seeing as how you cannot apprehend me without losing your town, and I cannot move the buildings without sacrificing my freedom, that you simply let me go.
Come on, you ain't serious.
Let me go. Keep what buildings remain, and you will never hear from me again.
He's lying. Him and Percy's crossing their fingers.
Tarnation! Chip, can you deny you saw a portion of my big picture?
Your song's getting tired, Roosterfur. Time to pack it in.
Belfry, I know you and I have had our differences, but take this moment right now to save your father. Join me and make the bat singer name Ascendant, as it was meant to be.
Sounds like you talking about some kind of determinatism. Like the name Bat Singer's supposed to mean something. Well, I think it means sneak, bully, and a cheat. There ain't nothing special about us save what we do with our time. And I see right through you, Daddy. You're about as hollow as a straw man.
Woo, you tell him, Belfry. I mean, it's something to think about. Especially him.
I see. Well, maybe I just pull this lever anyway.
And if you pull it, do we lose the library?
Yes, I already said.
I don't think you've thought this through.
Hey, Percy.
What do you want?
Look what I got.
Dynamite. I bet it's fake. Where'd you get that anyway?
The mines.
Let me hold it.
I make you a bet.
What?
Whoever can get to the top of those stairs the fastest by all them glow barrels get to set off my dynamite stick.
I don't know.
Okay, then. I'll do it myself.
I'll do it.
Ready? Set?
Well, if it's a building on stilts, I don't think that counts at all.
Me neither, and I still ain't convinced that tents is buildings.
Yeah, there's no way a tent's gonna zoop over. Keep dreaming.
Enough! Y'all done made me so furious, I'm beyond rational thought. I surprise myself with the sheer frustration and madness you have stirred in my soul. And so I resolve this day to seal all our fates, but to ruin your future by pulling this here lever.
No, Daddy.
What are you doing?
Now watch this, Percy. Watch your father teach his son and all these folks here a lesson. Percy? Percy, where have you gone?
Ghoulie kablooey!
Good night! Look out now!
Percy, what have you done?
What just happened up there?
He talking about some ghoulie kablooey, and somehow he blew up all them fright barrels. This whole building's gonna come down right on top of us.
Hey guys, is that pumpkin riding out of the flames on Percy's back as if unto glory? Whee! Y'all, we gotta run.
Hey, you okay? Loopy says fright levels are maxed like 1,000%.
That's awesome news. I want to hear all about it, but we are currently running from a burning building because Pumpkin and Percy just blew up all Roosterfer's fright barrels.
Now we're overwhelming. Hey, you did it. You overcharged the cones. Now we can reset the system, but you need to get over here fast.
Come on, Nita.
Be right there, Minerva.
Nita, we just saw Roosterfer go down that hallway. We're gonna chase after him. You good?
Yeah, headed to the ice cream tower.
Get that title back, Caretaker von Wangencamp. This town needs you, and I like using your office.
You got it, Chip. Good luck. Whee! I get off here.
Steady on, Percy. We shall make for the loophole and evade the hounds on our heels.
I don't want to go home. I want to stay here and watch little rascals and play Grave Station.
You have ruined us, Percy, but I will deal with you later. Now open the door so we may quit this town for another century.
Surprise!
Confound it! Move aside, Chip Clearly. I warn you, I have powers not yet revealed.
First you need to say hello to somebody I think you know pretty well.
Roosterfer!
Big Mama!
And Percy! You have ruined your clothes! Come here! Let me clean those cheeks! They are just filthy!
I told Big Mama how you was mean to my friends and tried to steal my candy. She come through the loophole.
Daddy, you might want to grab a seat. Big Mama got some ideas about y'all's punishment.
You two have been very bad boys. I believe I hear Bonita coming.
Bloopy, enter caretaker mode.
Hello, I'm Bloopy. Looks to me like you're opening a new franchise. Congratulations! Bloopy's operates thousands of locations all over space and time. Welcome to the family!
Hey, Nita, I've got Bloopy ready for you.
Thanks, Minerva. Hey, Bloop.
To begin, please use your caretaker imprimatur.
My name is Bonita von Wangencamp, and I approve this message.
Welcome, caretaker, Bone T. Van Wangencamp.
Close enough.
Now you will need to create a new password. Please enter the old password.
Okay. Albert was the first person to change the password in, like, forever. I scream, exclamation point.
That is not the correct old password. You have two tries remaining.
Bloopy!
Now, Miss Von Wangencamp, take a deep breath. Your team is handling Roosterfer, and we have a moment to think.
So, ice cream exclamation point isn't the default password. Some maniac just made that the password hundreds of years ago, and then nobody ever changed it. Okay, whatever.
Bloopy here with a tooltip. The password I'm thinking of was changed 5 alt 12th of midnight.
A very ancient date. I believe that is the town's founding date.
Okay, so it's probably something with the town motto.
Serve soft, large or small.
That is not the correct old password. You have one try remaining.
Oh, wait. Bloopy's was an ice cream parlor before it was the mysterious center of all the town's power, whatever on that. But the town seal actually says, soft serve, large or small. Exclamation point.
Welcome, caretaker Bone Teeth Von Wangencamp. You are now the proud owner of a Bloopy's franchise.
Okay, I can't believe that worked.
I didn't doubt you for a moment, Madam Caretaker. Your ghoulish blend of guts and brains is what makes you a good leader.
Roddy.
Press 1 to read the list of flavors. Press 2 to order more pointy hats for your soda jerks. Press 3 to release your magical town artifacts.
3.
Please pick up your town ledger from the drive-thru window. Have a Bloopy day.
Bloopy, enter admin mode. Look, Nita. You have the only user profile. Nobody can pull a stunt like Roosterfur did ever again.
Good. I guess the next caretaker will just have to make a new profile.
And we all believe that won't be for a very long time.
Y'all, the flooded mine.
Welcome to Country Rock Caverns, Nita, home of the Banshee roller coaster.
Thank you, Chip. You can stop saying that, as we have been here 2 hours already.
And we've barely seen half the things on this map. I want to ride the guillotine, the Gravitron, Mr. Buford's bounce house, get Elmer's autograph, and look, Nita, the twisted teacups.
Did you know the teacups are actually mining carts from way back 2 weeks ago when this place was an old mining town called Company Holler?
How interesting.
We had so much fright power after Halloween that we could clean up all Roosterfur's old mining junk and still have enough for this bonkers amusement park with creepy rides and games and the slowest line for snacks I have ever seen. What is going on up there?
Hey, Rochester, Minerva, where have you guys been?
Love Tunnel.
We sunk the most boats of all the lovers.
Is that what you're supposed to do?
I don't know.
Good evening, y'all.
Albert!
Hey, Albert, my man! How's it going?
I see you found a big old thing of candy corn.
I plan to eat the whole sleeve while enjoying the ponderous pace of the classic car ride.
Very underrated ride, the classic cars.
Aw, that does sound fun. Chip, I want to do classic cars after this.
We'll get the hearse with the batwing fenders.
You know, I used to own a car just like that.
Here we go.
It's a bed every Halloween.
Yes. Did it get good mileage?
Yes, to summit the crash.
Finally, we're next in line.
Hey, Roosterfur. How's it going?
I'll have you know it is hot as dickens. I'm out of change. Children want soda by the boatload, some with the most preposterous flavors, and I cannot fathom this register. So I beg you, in the name of Grand Supreme, keep your order very simple.
Give me a dozen salted slugs, torture rack ribs, Wootsie Wingos, Bat Babies, and cheese fries with extra salt. And a sludgy. But no ice. I mean a lot of ice. Okay? And a straw and ketchup.
And I will have Astral ice cream, rainbow skitters, dripping clots.
I don't even see that on here.
And you carry the drink, Chip, but I get to drink it whenever I want. And gummy worms. Please?
No, hold on. You
said... Okay. Can you mix flavors on the sludgy?
Well, I'm not sure. I have to... Percy, be careful.
Whoops! Dropped it!
I wish I never would have come to Curdle Holler.
Roosterfur!
Uh-oh!
The line is stacking up again! 5 deep is unacceptable! I'm bored, Mama. I want to ride the Hangman. Get your book satchel, Percy, and do your lessons right now.
Roostifer, I need to change my order because I didn't know you had slimy, grimy sticks, and I want a half order of those in the same container as the salt slugs, okay? And another ketchup.
You said 8 o'clock.
Roostifer, look what happens when you hair off on one of your shenanigans rambles. You need to serve these people, Roostifer. They've been very patient. And where is my sludgy cola? I'm thirsty, Roostifer. Are you listening, Roostifer?
Catching up on paperwork. I know, Venus, you don't like when I sing.
Miss Von Wangencamp, what's this line you wrote in the town ledger? I can't always read your little curlicues.
That is a 1,000 zap consultation fee to Henry Vex. I'm going to see if he can come up with some mad science way to plug up the Earth loophole.
Well, he ought to do it for free. Man don't need all them zaps. What's he going to spend it on? Some kind of Tedler coil or Edison kinetophone?
Belfry, I can tell you don't know a ton about science, but your heart's in the right place. Also, did you know that you can do your job at your house?
Well, maybe I like hanging around here.
Mm-hmm. We all like hanging around here, Madam Caretaker. It's where the action is.
Well, good morning, Sheriff. What are you doing in the boutique slash my office?
Just my morning jaw patrol.
That means...
That means I'm walking around running my mouth.
Doing a bang-up job.
Hey, my man Rochester. Boutique's looking good.
Why, thank you, Sheriff. We were quite pleased to see that it respawned after Pumpkin blew up all of Roostifer's fright barrels. It feels as though an ancient wrong has been righted.
What, so like all that fright power come atomized in the air and dispersed back into the town?
Something like that, according to Minerva.
Hey, you hear how I figured that out now, Belfry? Now, I am a man of science. You know why that old, you remember that old science fair at school, you know, talking about them old, big old poster boards, and they'd be like three sides of one. And, you know.
Good morning, Boutique. Good morning, Mr. Rochester and Mr. Collector. Good morning, Madam Caretaker.
Miss Weaver.
Oh, look, she's typing on her computer like she means business.
Adorable.
Morning, Mrs. Weaver. That is an extraordinarily large satchel you have with you this morning.
Look, I was doing some decluttering, and I thought I would see if your store might like to purchase some of my old things.
Collector?
Is it more country rock critters?
Is it?
Yes, but it's the whole set.
I'll give you 2 zaps for the Halloween critter, and 1 zap for the rest of them all together. We have an abundance of these collectibles.
Sold! Get it out of my gift wrap closet, you know?
Buddy, Susan, I have some more collectibles for you, my children.
Yay! We're gonna play with these in the dumpster.
Yeah, and then we might leave them there.
Yes, behold, again.
I have too many of that one. Give me more of that one.
Well, what do you have there? Is it stone on his tummy?
Okay, Mr. Fly, you're in space number 10. Enjoy Food Truck Tuesday.
Concessions.
Chip, I am loving our new side hustle in the boutique parking lot. Food Truck Tuesday is an excellent venue to showcase my newest craft beers.
It's good synergy, and it's great for the community.
Toot toot! Chili truck coming through! Come on, Foreman! Yeah, he's excited, y'all.
You're in space number 2, Goblina!
What? I better back up.
Okay, but watch out for Pastor Munch. He's right behind you.
What? Better not run over the preacher.
I am so glad to see that the mysterious straw man Foreman, who was so helpful to our cause, has settled into town. I was also glad to see that many of the straw man scarecrows have since transformed into various other monsters.
It's the magic of fright power. New citizens, monster makeovers, and a bright new future. Man, I love this town.
As do I.
I'm sorry to bother y'all, but can you help me carry this big old box inside the boutique? It's kind of falling apart on me.
Sure thing. What you got there, Pastor Munch?
Well, I was hoping I could scare up a little money to start my holiday shopping, so I decided to gather up all my country rock critters and see if y'all would buy them for a fair price.
Pastor, We'll help you carry these critters, but I wouldn't get my hopes up about the price.
Oh, we hate you have to go. It's time to say bye-bye. Though we are already dead, we're dying to have you come back next time.
Now, Pumpkin, isn't this better than your video game?
You can fish in video games.
Well, you can't fish in a video game on Willifred Thorn Bridge with an old friend and colleague, can you?
What was that, Granddaddy?
There's no telling, for many strange things swim beneath the bridge, and still stranger things lie beyond it. Things we may never understand. You caught something, Pumpkin. Reel it in.
A turtle.
That's 5 turtles now, Pumpkin. It defies explanation.
My pole is witched.
No, that's the regular pole.
What's that noise in the forbidden woods?
It seems to be some alien utility vehicle. It must have passed through the magic barrier. But that shouldn't be possible for 2 more Halloweens.
I'ma see who it is.
Yes, we'd better have a look.
It's Bubby Kentucky.
Hey there, fellas. Bobby Carnuckle, your designated level 1 technician.
Mr. Carnuckle, what brings you to Curdle Holler? I thought we were under a strict no-contact order from the council.
Well, you was, but the Elsewhere Council is seriously concerned.
Why concerned?
Let's just say, it's very important I find a fella named Henry Vex.
Oh dear.
Let me show you my turtles I caught, Bubba Kentucky.
Be a ghoul boss, baby, for work in the mines. Be a ghoul boss, baby. It's your time to be a ghoul boss, baby. Now use your plan. Put on your high-heeled shoes and stand up to the man. Sing it, dog.